Here with new 2021 quarterback, Georgia commit, Brock Vandegrift, five-star for us on Rivals.com. Brock, first off, congrats. Got the G, red, black. I mean, Georgia's literally like right down the road. And we'll start with that. Obviously, we know family played a big role in this. You're a family guy close to your, obviously, your parents, but grandparents too over in Alabama. One-time Oklahoma commit, Georgia, obviously, Athens, much closer than Norman, Oklahoma. How much did that, or they, play a role in this?
I would say that's probably, like, the primary factor is just whenever I was over Christmas break and stuff like that, I was just wanting to stay closer to home and just my parents and my grandparents just being around them. I was like, I don't think I can go across the country for something I can do, like, 10 minutes away.
Well, when did that hit you? Was there a certain moment? A conversation where you sitting at home, when did that hit you, man? I might not can go that far.
I would just say it was over like a period of time because I mean, I was praying about it for a while, and then just keeping on recruiting me and stuff like meant a lot to me. And then whenever Kirby came on the helicopter, that was pretty neat. And just I think it was over like the 25th, 26th, 27th. It just kind of like it was like I think this is what's right for me, and I think this is what God is telling me to do. So I just went with it.
You know, taking the family, you know, out of the equation a little bit, talk more about Georgia. Why you feel UGA, Kirby Smart, that program's right for you?
I think it's good for me because, I mean, I can go in and bring some diversity to the quarterback position, I believe. Maybe extend some plays and stuff like that. And I think there's just something about playing for your home team that I didn't realize at first, but something like just representing the state of Georgia.
Talk about Kirby a little bit. Obviously, talk about the Kirby copter coming in,
yeah.
Flying around. I mean, he's known from the time I've been in this business as a relentless recruiter, whether he's been at Georgia, LSU, Alabama. He's been a guy that's known to connect with players and just have that energy, enthusiasm. How would you describe him?
He's good. He's fun to be around, and he's energetic, and he always wants the best for you. And at practice, he's going to push you until you can almost be pushed no more. So, I mean, I would say, like, I want him on my team because he's going to expect the best out of me every day.
You know, we're going to get this question about you. I'll let you go ahead and answer it. How is this one, this commitment, different from the first one?
I would say it's, like, it's different, but then again, it's kind of the same because once I'm committed, like, I don't really, what's it called, plan on talking to anyone, taking any other visits, and then I would say this one is, like, is it for sure. I mean, I'm just get to every spring or the spring games that I have, every fall game that I have, just because it's 10 minutes away and why not. And then hoping to get over there a lot during the summer and be able to start working on the offense.
You know, you're literally at home at UGA. I mean, does it feel like that? I mean, you're just a few miles away. Mm-hmm. We're here at your high school right now. Your house is like a mile or two down the road, Georgia, 10 minutes from here. Do you feel that like you're right at home when you're on that campus?
Yes, sir. I mean, it's just good being able because I know I'm familiar with the campus, the coaches, and the players and stuff like that. So it does have a sense of like home to me, and so that's where I decided that I wanted to be.
I guess last question. Now that you're committed to Georgia, what will be, I guess, the way you watch the game maybe this year coming up compared to how you watched it in the past couple of years? Now that you're committed, you know you're going there, you're going to play in that offense or play for that coaching staff. Mm-hmm. How will you view, I guess, Georgia differently moving forward?
I think I'm going to stop, like, following the ball more and just stuff like that and be able to, like, see what I do on this play right here and, like, what are they looking at and stuff like that. And I'm not going to be as much as a fan of Georgia as I am a fan of the offense and a fan of the game.
Let me close with this one more time. Back to the family, kind of full circle. How do you feel? How do your parents feel? How do your grandparents feel? How does just your overall family feel and yourself about this decision?
The first thing my parents and grandparents said to me was just like, well, Brock, we want what's right for you and we want what's best for you, but I'm going to love being able to come to every game and stuff like that. And just they were like, I mean, we would have had to make it work going to Oklahoma, but they were like, I'm so glad that you're closer to home. They're like, I don't care that it's Georgia. I don't care if it's freaking Georgia Tech. They were like, I want to be able to see that you're happy, and I want to be able to try to come to every game. So it was special to me, and like my great-grandparents are still living, and they were like, Brock, we want to come watch you and stuff like that. And it was just pulling on my heartstrings.
But Georgia won out. Five-star quarterback Brock Vandegrift. Congratulations, man.
Yes, sir. Thank you.